الله أكبر الله أكبر الله.
Another busy day begins for the Khalifa of Islam. Over the next 365 days, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih's daily routine will see him lead thousands of prayers, deliver dozens of Friday sermons, reply to countless letters, and meet tens of thousands of members of his community. But this is only a glimpse into his busy schedule, for what lies ahead is an agenda that is incomparable to any agenda. Throughout the year, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih will grace various events, address countless dignitaries and influential people, spread the message of the true Islam, and most importantly, guide the members of the community ever closer to Allah the Almighty. This is a year in the life of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih. Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, the Khalifa of Islam. Hazur has been divinely bestowed the responsibility for the guidance of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat. This may seem an impossible task, as millions of Ahmadi Muslims are spread over 200 countries around the world. But by the grace and blessings of Allah, MTA International is the perfect tool for not only guiding and training his community, but to spread the true message of Islam. This is the link between Hazrat Khalifatul Masih and the world. And that is why great emphasis is laid to ensure that MTA continues to achieve its purpose.
The truly great blessing and prayer Allah has granted the Jamaat in the form of MTA. Certainly, and with the grace of Allah, people are starting to realize that our teachings represent the true Islam. We are now seeing that the focus and attention of the world is moving in the direction of Ahmadiyya. The reach of the Jamaat through all forms of media, whether broadcast, print, or electronic, is continuing to increase. In North America, Europe, Africa, Australia, and elsewhere, the Jamaat is starting to receive much more media coverage, and so millions of people are now becoming aware of our teachings. And so I hope and pray that Allah the Almighty continues to bless us with such people who are able to serve MTA with sincerity and a spirit of true devotion. I hope and pray that we are able to take full benefit of this great treasure that Allah has bestowed upon us, so that the message of true Islam shines brightly and comes to enlighten every home in the world.
Through the blessings of Allah the Almighty, MTA International uses the latest technological advancements to link Ahmadis around the world with their beloved Khalifa and to spread the message all over the globe. For example, the two-way link is frequently used to create a platform where Ahmadis sitting thousands of miles away can experience the presence of their master live within their very homes.
जब कभी तुमको मिले मौका दुआए खास का याद कर लेना हमें अहले वफाए कादियां. याद कर लेना हमें अहले वफाए खादियां.
This weekend you have held your ijtema here in Islamabad, and similarly the Khudamul Ahmadiyya in the United States have also held their national ijtema and are listening to my address today directly through MTA. Thus today all of you should make a firm pledge that you will be the people who will seek to protect Islam from all of the attacks of it faces, and you will be the people who seek to spread its peaceful teachings far and wide.
Aaj Allah Taala ke fazl se Jamaat Ahmadiyya Bangladesh ka jalsa salana apne ikhtitam ko pahunch raha hai. Ye jalsa kya hai? Yaqeenan muqarrin ne aur shayad iftah karne wale ne aapko bataya hoga, balki har saal hi bataya jata hai کہ حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کا جلسوں کے انعقاد کا مقصد کوئی دنیاوی مقصد نہیں تھا، بلکہ اپنی جماعت کے افراد کے تقویٰ کے معیار کو اونچا کرنا مقصد تھا.
رہبر کے لیے دوستو.
The جلسہ that are graced by the presence of خلیفۃ المسیح hold special importance. The annual Germany Jalsa is one such a momentous occasion, as Hazrat Khalifat al-Masih blesses the three-day event with his presence. Over the course of the convention, Hazur's various awe-inspiring addresses are the highlight of the convention and treasure for all participants. One such address is delivered on the second day of the Germany Jalsa, where Hazur addresses the non-Ahmadi guests at the convention. This year's address covered the fact that Ahmadi Muslims are the true promoters of peace, and unlike other Muslims, they are the followers of the true Islam.
Let me first of all make it clear that Ahmadi Muslims are entirely sincere in their efforts to promote peace in the world and always endeavor to practice what they preach. We are the same from the inside as the outside, and live our lives according to what we believe in our hearts to be true Islam. I would also like to make it clear that when Ahmadi Muslims spread teachings of peace, security, and love for all, they are not presenting anything new, but are manifesting only the true teachings of Islam. In every respect, Islam is a religion of peace, harmony, tolerance, and compassion.
This is only one of the many events in which His Holiness addresses the world about the true message of Islam. In this day and age, it is only Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, the supreme head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat, who is delivering this service of defending Islam. But his efforts were taken to new heights as the world witnessed a horrific side of so-called Islam. The year 2014 brought along another important turning point in history when so-called Islamists once again tarnished Islam. Islam was once again branded as a religion of terrorism and violence. But it was the head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat, once again, who took up the painstaking task of showing the true beauties of Islam. In wake of these events, it was for the first time ever the Ahmadiyya Muslim Jamaat UK held two-piece symposia instead of one in a year. The highlight of both symposia was the keynote address of His Holiness, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad. Firstly, on the 8th of November 2014, His Holiness addressed the dignitaries condemning the activities of ISIS and proved from the Holy Quran that this group had no relation to Islam. His Holiness proved that Islam was in fact a religion of peace.
Over the past year, One particular group has viciously spread its network of terror and has become a cause of major concern for the world. I'm speaking of the group of extremists commonly known as ISIS or IS. The actions of this extremist group are not only impacting Muslim countries, but also countries in Europe and further afield are also being affected by its brutalities. The fact that all of this is being done in the name of Islam sincerely grieves and pains all true and peace-loving Muslims, because such brutal and inhuman ideologies have nothing to do with the religion whatsoever. Rather, in every way and at every level, Islam's real teachings are of peace and security for all people.
The second of these conferences was held in March 2015. His Holiness urged the Western powers and influential people to adopt justice and to recognize their responsibilities.
In terms of extremism, let it be absolutely clear that wherever and whenever anyone seeks to justify their hate-filled atrocities or injustices in the name of Islam, they should be condemned. Let it also be very clear that such acts have no relation whatsoever to the true and peaceful teachings of Islam. There is no doubt that major powers and certain political and religious leaders are motivated by greed and their vested interests. Their selfish desires have contributed to the desperate state of affairs that we are witnessing, and so responsibility also lies with them. The world is being consumed by various issues that are leading to frustration and resentment, which in turn are undermining peace. Seated before me are various politicians, influential figures, and well-educated people, and so I wish to reiterate that you should all try your level best to influence your governments and leaders positively towards establishing justice and honesty at all levels. These are the keys to solving the many international and domestic crises of our time.
Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad emphasized on a similar topic at his reception of the recently inaugurated Maria Mosque in Ireland on the 26th of September 2014. The head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community was welcomed by the mayor and other dignitaries to the city and considered it an honor of being present at this momentous occasion.
I would like to take this opportunity to welcome His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad to Galway and say you're very, very welcome here to the City of the Tribes. It is an honor and a privilege as Mayor of Galway to be here at the public inauguration of Maria Mosque, Mosque of Mary in Galway. This is indeed a historic moment as Galway witnesses the opening of its first ever mosque, Masjid Mariam, which is a symbol of peace and love for the people of Galway and of Ireland.
The Khalifa of Islam addressed the 170 dignitaries and guests, condemning all forms of terrorism, and explained that the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, was a mercy for mankind. Hence this mosque, like all other Ahmadi mosques around the world, will prove to be a symbol of peace.
In light of this, I say without any hesitation that there are many so-called Muslims who are perpetrating the very greatest evils in the name of Islam. However, I should also make it clear that such reprehensible conduct by Muslim groups or governments do not in any shape or form reflect Islam's true teachings. On the contrary, Islam is that religion which has taught Muslims to live their lives by treating one another with love, compassion, and mercy. All of our mosques are centers of peace and harmony, where those who seek to unite mankind through love join together to promote mutual harmony, to worship and to pray for the peace, safety, and well-being of all mankind.
During his visit to Ireland, the Supreme Head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Community, Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, was invited to the National Irish Parliament, where he was given a presidential reception from the parliamentarians. His Holiness answered questions regarding the teachings of the Holy Quran and the Holy Prophet of Islam, and explained the work the community does to create peace in the world. The month of January was an extremely delicate and dangerous period for the Islamic world. The depiction of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, of Islam by a French satirical magazine had enraged the Muslims all around the world. The consequence saw brutal attacks being carried out in Paris by so-called Muslims, hence giving the world another chance to defame Islam and its teachings. But the champion of Islam again stood up against the world to prove that Islam is in fact a message of love and the Holy Prophet was the Prince of Peace.
फ्रांस में जो एक ज़ालमाना वाक़िया हुआ है और इस्लाम और हज़रत सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के नाम पर जिसका इस्लाम की तालीम से दूर कभी वास्ता नहीं कानून हाथ में लेकर किसी को इस तरह मारना कत्ल करना ये हम हमेशा कहते हैं कि इस्लाम की तालीम से इसका वास्ता नहीं और साबित करते हैं कि तालीम से वास्ता नहीं लेकिन फिर भी नाम नहाद मुसलमान और ये मुसलमान तंजीमें अपनी हरकतों से और इन जुल्मों से बाज नहीं आते गुज़श्ता दिनों फ्रांस में जो हालात हुए और मुसलमान कहलाने वालों ने एक अखबार के दफ्तर पर हमला करके जो 12 आदमियों को मार दिया उसके बारे में मुख्तसर ज़िक्र करके गुज़श्ता जुमे में मैंने अहमदियों को अफराद जमात को दुरूद पढ़ने की तरफ तवज्जो दिलाई थी कि कत्ल वारत गरी से इस्लाम की फतह नहीं हो बल्कि आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम पर दुरूद भेजने से हम अपने मकसद में कामयाब हो सकेंगे काश के मुसलमान तंजीमें जो इस्लाम के नाम पर जुल्म करती हैं समझें कि इस्लाम की प्यार और मोहब्बत की तालीम ज़्यादा जल्दी दुनिया को इस्लाम की आगोश में ला सकती है इस्लाम जिस तरह सब्र और हौसले की तालीम देता है उसका कोई दूसरा मज़हब मुकाबला ही नहीं कर सकता इस मरतबा ये भी पहली मरतबा हुआ है कि इस वाक़े के बाद यूके और दुनिया के मुख्तलिफ मीडिया ने जमात से भी हमारा रद्द अमल या मौक़िफ इस बारे में पूछा जिसमें हमने इस कत्ल के वाक़े के बारे में बताया कि यह गैर इस्लामी फेल है और हम इस पर अफसोस करते हैं लेकिन आज़ादी राय की भी कुछ हदूद होनी चाहिए वरना दुनिया में फसाद पैदा करने के ज़िम्मेदार वो लोग होंगे जो दूसरों के जज्बात को अंगेख्त करते हैं बहरहाल उसके अलावा इस तफसीली बातें कुछ बयान हुई हैं प्रेस में यूके में स्काई न्यूज़ न्यूज़ 5 बीबीसी रेडियो एलबीसी बीबीसी लीड्स और लंदन लाइव फिर बाहर के टीवी हैं फॉक्स टीवी है सीएनएन है कनाडा के अखबार हैं इस तरह यूनान आयरलैंड फ्रांस अमेरिका के मुख्तलिफ अखबार हैं इन्होंने हमारा मौक़िफ़ बयान किया
انٹرویو ان کے اسٹوڈیوز میں جا کے بھی ہوئے ہیں اور کئی ملین لوگوں تک اسلام کا حقیقی موقف اور تعلیم پہنچی اس طریقے سے.
اس طرف احرار یورپ کا مزاج.
Due to certain situations in the Islamic world over the past few years, the Ahmadiyya Muslim community has seen an increase in media coverage. The whole world is curious and eager to find out why this community doesn't partake in terrorism, and why is this community different? And most importantly, how can we establish world peace? Our beloved Khalifa has been at the forefront in spreading this message to the corners of the world. The international media can no longer turn a blind eye to this magnificent service of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, the supreme head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, is approached by many TV and radio channels and the print media when they go out in pursuit of the true message of Islam.
For those non-Muslim people listening to you, who will welcome all your words of peace, I'm sure, and welcome all that they can learn about the Ahmadiyya community. But they will also want, for example, the right to offend, the right to, for the Charlie Hebdo magazine to do the cartoon it did the week after the killings, that they'll want a number of things to be okay on the streets of Britain and in the magazines of Britain and in conversations. What do you say to those people who fear that your message might be, you can't do this?
So somebody wrote that right to offend does not mean to offend is right. But so, see, we need some harmony and peace in the world. If such actions are welcomed or fanned by the media or by any of the society organization, then you cannot establish peace in the world. So every person, every organization, all the media should realize their responsibility and play their role, as I've said,
to act peacefully,
to cool down the people, to give good news to the people instead of inciting them.
Similarly, Hazu was interviewed by a national weekly German newspaper during his tour of Germany.
Kuch arse se duniya Boko Haram aur ISIS ki khilafat کے بارے میں سنتی ہے, مگر خلافت احمدیت اور اس خلافت جو ہم جس کے جرمنوں کو جو سنتے ہیں اس میں فرق کیا ہے؟
اسلام ہے حکمت کا مذہب. اسلام نے ہر بات کی ایک دلیل دی ہے. اسلام نے بنیادی طور پر کہا کہ خلافت کا تعلق نبوت کے ساتھ ہے. آ حضرت صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا کہ تم میں خلافت پہلے نبوت ہے, پھر خلافت اللہ منہاج نبوت ہے, اسی طریقے پہ چلنے والی نبوت ہے, خلافت ہے جو نبوت کے اصول پہ چلے گی. نبوت کا اصول کیا تھا؟ نبوت کا اصول یہی تھا کہ انصاف کرو, عدل کرو, خدا تعالیٰ کی طرف لے کر آؤ, ہیں رحم کرو. اگر ظلم ہی ظلم تھا تو اللہ تعالیٰ اپنے آپ کو رحمان اور رحیم نہ کہتا.
An important part of the peace symposiums are the sittings with various press representatives that are held after the event. Hazur is interviewed by both the Pakistani media and the international media separately. A message of peace and service to mankind is echoed throughout all of Hazur's interviews and speeches. This is one of the great services of His Holiness Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmad, to call the world to believe in the one God and His Messenger, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. The Jamaat, responding to the call of their beloved Khalifa, has taken this into a practical form as well, with establishment of various organizations such as IAAAE and Humanity First. Hazur ensures that the community is at the forefront of serving mankind. Hazur addressed the IAAAE European Symposium on the 2nd of May, in which he explained that service to humanity was a major part of Islam, and presented the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, as the role model for all of man.
The humanitarian work conducted by the Ahmadiyya Muslim community is rendered entirely selflessly and without any desire for worldly reward. This is not only because it is a basic moral obligation to help others, but also due to the fact that serving humanity is an essential part of our faith as Muslims. Similarly, the Holy Prophet repeatedly said that it was essential to fulfill the rights of mankind. If we look at his own blessed example, we see that in every possible way he served humanity and forever sacrificed his own comfort in order to provide comfort and ease to others.
Hazu delivered a similar message at the concluding address of the Humanity First conference. Hazu explained the purpose for the establishment of Humanity First.
Certainly, this is the very basis and purpose with which Humanity First was named. That, first of all, humanity and one's own prayer and comfort is secondary. Thus, every person associated with Humanity First, whether they are part of its executive body, or whether they are workers or volunteers, should understand this philosophy and this spirit. Every member should utilize their abilities and skills for the sake of others and should be ready to accept any form of discomfort, hardship, or sacrifice for the sake of giving ease and comfort to those who are in need or who have been deprived in any way. They should not seek any worldly reward, but their sole motivation should be the love and prayer of God the Almighty. Certainly, the scale of the work being done by Humanity First far exceeds the funds that it has available. Other charities could not do 10% of the work that Humanity First does with the same amount of money. This is all a result of Allah's grace and blessings, and you should remember this at all times.
In Islam, a mosque symbolizes a place of worship, peace, and solitude. Throughout his tenure, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih has laid the foundation stones and inaugurated a great number of mosques around the world. Whether it be Europe, the Far East, or the Far West, the message that is echoed from these mosques is always the same, the message of the Holy Quran. Hazur has repeatedly said that these mosques are a beacon from which the light of peace and the true Islam shall illuminate the world. By the grace and blessings of Allah, on the 26th of September 2014, Hazur inaugurated the first purpose-built mosque in Ireland. In his Friday sermon, Hazrat Khalifatul Masih emphasized that the purpose for Ahmadi mosques all over the world is the same, the worship of God and service to man.
अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह आज हमें आयरलैंड में जमात अहमदिया मुस्लिमा की पहली मस्जिद में अल्लाह ताला जुमा पढ़ने की तौफीक अता फरमा रहा है अल्लाह ताला इस मस्जिद की तामीर इसका क़याम हर लिहाज से बबरकत फरमाए ये मसाजिद इस बात का ऐलान करने के लिए हम तमीर करते हैं कि दुनिया के फसादों को दूर करने के लिए इस्लाम की उस खूबसूरत तालीम पर गौर करो جو محبت پیار صلح اور امن کا پیغام دیتی ہے. یہ مساجد اس بات کے اعلان کے لیے ہیں کہ دنیا کو محبت پیار اور بھائی چارے کی ضرورت ہے, نہ کہ جنگ و جدل کی, نہ کہ تلوار اور توپ کی. یہ مساجد جو ہم تعمیر کرتے ہیں اس بات کا اعلان کرتی ہیں کہ اس مسجد میں آنے والے کا دل ہر قسم کے ظلموں اور حقوق وصف کرنے کے خیالات سے پاک ہے. یہ ہماری مساجد اس بات کا نشان اور مرکز ہیں کہ یہاں آنے والے دوسروں کے حقوق کی ادائیگی کے لیے ہر قسم کی قربانی کرنے والے ہیں.
In the early days of June, the soil of Germany was graced with blessed presence of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih. During Hazu's two-week stay, four mosques all over the country were inaugurated with the blessed hands of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih. Hazu's first stop was in the historic city of Aachen on the western border of Germany, where Hazu inaugurated the Bayt al-Mansur Mosque. A special reception to commemorate the event saw many dignitaries, officials, members of parliament, and other prominent members attend the event. The Lord Mayor delivered a speech in which he welcomed Hazur to Aachen and congratulated the community on the inauguration of the mosque.
Guter Tag, ein freudiger Tag. Zum einen, weil wir ein neues Gotteshaus haben, was wir zu Recht feiern. Zum anderen aber auch, weil diese Einweihung der Moschee der Ahmadiyya-Muslime ohne hitzige Debatten, ohne aufgeregte mediale Diskussion, ohne Streit und ohne Hader vorbereitet werden konnte.
The highlight of the reception was of course the address of Khalifat al-Masih. Hazu reminded the attendees of their prime purpose.
بس یہ خوبصورت تعلیم ہے جو اللہ تعالیٰ قرآن کریم میں ہمیں دیتا ہے کہ دنیاوی چیزوں سے فائدہ ضرور اٹھاؤ, لیکن یہ بھی یاد رکھو کہ تمہارا مقصد ایک خدا کی عبادت کرنا بھی ہے اور اس خدا کے بندوں کے حقوق ادا کرنا بھی ہے.
Over 290 kilometers away, a similar beacon of peace and love was inaugurated at the hands of Hazur. The inauguration of the Bayt al-Wahid Mosque in the German city of Hanau was held on the 27th of May, which marked the 107th year of the establishment of Khilafat.
اس بارے میں بتایا گیا کہ یہاں ایک سپر مارکیٹ ہوتی تھی اور اس سپر مارکیٹ میں لوگ جاتے ہیں اپنی گروسری خریدنے کے لیے, شاپنگ کرنے کے لیے, مختلف ضروریات کو پورا کرنے کے لیے اور رقم خرچ کرتے ہیں. لیکن یہاں اس سپر مارکیٹ کو اب جو تبدیل کیا گیا ہے مسجد میں, تو یہاں اس میں دنیاوی اور مادی چیزیں تو نہیں ملیں گی, لیکن یہ ایک خدا کا گھر بنایا گیا ہے, اس خدا کا گھر جس نے کہا کہ میری عبادت بھی کرو اور اعلیٰ اخلاقی قدروں کا بھی اظہار کرو, اپنے ہمسایوں کے حقوق بھی ادا کرو اور امن اور محبت کی فضا بھی قائم کرو. بس اب اس جگہ شہر کے لوگوں کے لیے, رہنے والوں کے لیے یہ مال میسر آئے گا, یہ چیزیں میسر آئیں گی جو بغیر کسی قیمت کی ادائیگی کے میسر آ سکتی ہیں.
On the 9th of June, Hazur inaugurated the Bayt al-Qadir Mosque in the city of Feshta. Hazur led the Zuhr and Asr prayers and also planted a tree. In the evening, Hazur graced a reception which was attended by over 170 dignitaries. Hazur's inspiring keynote address was again the highlight of the evening. The city of Iserlohn was blessed with the laying of a foundation stone for the Bayt al-Salam Mosque. A formal session which was attended by over 50 dignitaries saw many influential people welcoming Hazur to the city and congratulating the community on the achievement. In his keynote address, Hazoor reminded the community of their responsibilities of spreading peace and love. Finally, a five-story administrative building was inaugurated, named Beit al-Afiyat. It will provide offices for the Ansar and Lajna of Frankfurt, from which they can continue work of the community in a more professional manner. One of the objectives of the advent of the Promised Messiah was to guide his community to a relationship with Allah the Almighty. Not only his community, rather his target was the whole of mankind. However, such a strenuous task could not be achieved by one man alone. Jamia Ahmadiyya is one such institute that has been established for this very purpose. Hazoor graces the students of Jamia Ahmadiyya UK with various sittings and constantly reminds them of their responsibilities as future missionaries. But the flagship event of Jamia is of course the convocation of the batch that is qualified as new missionaries. This year's convocation, once again, saw Hazoor award the graduates with the Shahid degree and reminded them of their responsibilities.
Aaj Allah Taala ke fazl se aap mein se 22 talaba jo aakhri class ke shahid ke the muballigh aur murabbi ban kar nikal rahe hain. Allah Taala ye azaz har lihaz se aapko mubarak farmaye. Aap un logon mein shamil ho gaye hain جو تفقف دین کرنے کے بعد دنیا کو حق و صداقت دکھانے اور دنیا کو حق و صداقت پر چلانے کے لیے مقرر کیے گئے ہیں. بس سب سے پہلے تو آپ کو ہر وقت ہر لمحہ خود اپنے جائزے لینے کی ضرورت ہے کہ یہ ذمہ داری جو آپ پر پڑی ہے یہ ایک بہت بڑی ذمہ داری ہے. حق و صداقت بتانا اور سکھانا اور اس پر دنیا کو چلانا یہ کوئی معمولی کام نہیں ہے. یہ ایک بہت بڑی ذمہ داری ہے جس کو جیسا کہ میں نے کہا ہر وقت آپ کو اپنے سامنے رکھنا ہوگا, پیش نظر رکھنا ہوگا, تبھی آپ اپنی ذمہ داری کو آسن رنگ میں ادا کر سکیں گے.
Hazoor not only deals with their spiritual training but also focuses on their physical training.
Exercise جو ہے بڑی ضروری ہے اور exercise ایسی ہونی چاہیے کہ سارے جسم کو فٹ کرے. میدے کے پیٹ کے مسل جو ہیں وہ صحیح ہونے چاہیے, جن کے جسم بے ڈھبے ہو رہے ہیں وہ یہ دیکھیں کہ ہم نے کس طرح اپنے جسموں کو صحیح بھی رکھنا ہے اور صحت سے بھی رکھنا ہے, دونوں چیزیں ضروری ہیں.
Even though such people have been prepared to train the members of the community in working towards improving their spiritual state, streamline their lives and develop the habit of hard work, the main role is played by the head of our community. Hazrat Khalifatul Masih, being the spiritual father of the community, leaves no stone unturned to constantly guide the Jamaat to its prime objective. Throughout the year, various classes with the youth allows them to seek vital advice and training from their beloved Imam. Ijtima'at provide a perfect platform from where Hazoor can remind the Lajna, Nasirat, Atfal, members of the Waqf-e-Nau scheme, Ansar and Khuddam of their responsibilities. Hazoor addressed the Lajna on their national ijtima regarding the importance of the veil.
If Allah has prescribed some things which in certain situations women may consider difficult or even restrictive, then the reward from Allah will also be far greater. For example, where Allah has given the commandment to observe parda, He has also stated that God is He who is forgiving and merciful, and God's compassion, mercy and love will rain down upon those women who follow this command.
Another important landmark of the year was the congregational prayers led by Hazur when the solar eclipse was witnessed. According to the practice of the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, Hazur addressed a congregation at the Fazl Mosque, reminding us of the importance of eclipses, as stated by the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, and the promised Messiah, peace be on him.
Namaz-e-kusuf mein do rakat padhne ke baad sunnat ke mutabik ek khutba bhi diya jata hai. So iske mutabik grahan ke hawale se baaz hadith pesh karta hoon jisse aan hazrat sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke tareeq aur iski ahmiyat aur jo aapne sahi farmayi wo hamare samne aati hain. اس زمانے میں کسوف و خسوف کا حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ السلام سے بھی تعلق ہے. حضرت مسیح موعود علیہ السلام کی آمد کی ایک نشانی چاند اور سورج گرہن بھی تھا جس کے بارے میں آن حضرت صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی ایک لمبی حدیث ہے. اور یہ ایک ایسا نشان تھا جو پہلے کسی دعویٰ کرنے والے کے دعوے کی تائید میں ظاہر نہیں ہوا.
The upcoming Jalsa symbolizes the end of another eventful year for the Supreme Head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. This was merely a glimpse into Hazur's engagements throughout the year. The upcoming year will no doubt bring another full agenda. Another year begins for our beloved Imam to guide and train the members of his community. Another year as the custodian and champion of Islam. Another year to spread the message of the true Islam. Another year of the head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community. Another year of Hazrat Khalifatul Masih.